Let us discuss about the total electrostatic energy of a system of charges. As we already discussed when we were studying about the potential energy of a system of charges, we can always state that electrostatic potential energy of a system is equal to the work done in assembling the system of charges. Whenever some charges are assembled in a given configuration and shape, then some work is done. And we also discussed that if the charges are repelling each other, work will be done by the external agent and the system potential energy will be positive. And if the forces among charges is attractive, then the work will be done by the electric forces and the final potential energy of the system will be negative. So, whenever work is done, that is stored in form of electrostatic potential energy. One more important point to be understood here is, work done in assembling a system of charges in a given configuration, we are talking about a given charge configuration, is stored in form of field energy of electric field in the region where system of charges exist. In the previous section, we already discussed that whenever a body is charged, whatever work is done is stored in form of field energy in the surrounding of body if the body is isolated. The same is valid for a system of charges also. Whenever a system of charges are assembled in a given configuration, then whatever amount of work we do is stored in the region where the charges exist in form of the field energy of the electric field. So we can say, total electrostatic energy of a system can be given by one way of calculating the total electrostatic energy is total field energy associated with the system of charges of which we are calculating the total electrostatic energy. One way is this. Other way out is we can simply find out the total work done in assembling the system. And obviously when we are assembling the system, first we need to supply charges to the bodies and then bodies are assembled further. So we can simply write this total electrostatic energy can be calculated as sum of all self and interaction energies of the system of charges. So, whenever there are some bodies given to us which are charged, then the total electrostatic energy of the system can be written as sum of all self energies of the object as well as the total interaction energy of the system of charges. Let's continue on the next sheet. In continuation, let's discuss a system of uncharged object. Say we are given that in a system of uncharged bodies, the total electrostatic energy of this system can be given as, this can be simply written as total electrostatic energy is equal to summation of self energy of all objects. We can write U self II equals to 1 to N plus we can find out the interaction energy of all the pairs of the objects in the system, that can be written as half of summation I equals to 1 to n, summation j equals to 1 to n, u interaction ij. And here we just take care that I should not be equals to j. That means we never calculate the interaction energy of a body with itself. So this is the way how we can calculate, and it is same. The total interaction energy is sum of self energies of all bodies in system plus it will be sum of interaction energies of all pairs of objects or bodies in the system. In the previous topics of electrostatic potential energy, this section we already studied that in case of multi-object system, the total interaction energy of a system can be given by the sum of all pairs of objects in the system. Sum of interaction energies of all pairs of objects of the system, and in this section we have studied about the self energies also. So total self energy, total electrostatic energy of a system of bodies can be given as sum of self energies of bodies plus sum of all the interaction energies of the bodies in the system.